the ground. Scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate your response to this crisis?
I'd rate it a 10. I'd rate it a 10. I'd rate it a 10. I like this stuff. I really get it. People are surprised that I understand it. Every one of these doctors said, how do you know so much about this? Maybe I have a natural ability. Maybe I should have done that instead of running for president. People think that goes away in April with the heat, as the heat comes in. Typically, that will go away in April. We're in great shape there. You treat this like a flu.
15 people out of billions of people, 15 people, they're getting better. Mm-hmm. And soon they're all going to be better. Hopefully, it's going to disappear. One day, it's like a miracle. It will disappear.
Now the Democrats are politicizing the coronavirus. You know that, right? Coronavirus. And this is their new hoax.
So healthy people, if you're healthy, you will probably go through a process and you'll be fine. I've always known this is a pandemic. I felt it was a pandemic long before it was called a pandemic. All you had to do is look at other countries. So, America continues to wage all-out war to defeat the virus, this horrible, horrible virus. You see how terrible it is, especially when you look at the numbers from yesterday. Then I see the disinfectant, where it knocks it out in a minute. 1 minute, and is there a way we can do something like that by injection inside or almost a cleaning? Because you see it gets on the lungs and it does a tremendous number of the lungs. So it'd be interesting to check that. So that you're going to have to use medical doctors with. But it sounds interesting to me. And I say it, what do you have to lose? I'll say it again. What do you have to lose? Take it. I really think they should take it. But it's their choice. And it's the doctor's choice or the doctors in the hospital. But hydroxychloroquine, try it if you'd like.
Shut it down when we shut down the border, so to speak. We shut it down to China.
So when you say that I wasn't prepared, I was the first one to do the ban. Now other countries are following what I did. I was called a racist by Democrats, a racist. I was a racist because I decided that I didn't want to have people that could hurt our country come in. But I closed it down, and I was called names by some of the morning show hosts who don't have a clue what they're talking about. They're not smart people. And I made a decision to close off to China. Sleepy Joe Biden said, it's xenophobic. I don't know if he knows what that means, but that's okay. He said it's racist, what I did. Not only did we do it, but I did it very early. And that decision has been now given very good grades, like an A++++. I think we're doing a really good job. We're getting very high marks on it. We're getting high poll numbers, believe it or not.
We're giving, I think, really given tremendous marks. You look at Gallup poll, you look at other polls for the way we've handled it. We've gotten the highest poll numbers of anybody for this kind of a thing.
I guess I'm doing okay because, to the best of my knowledge, I'm the president of the United States, despite the things that are said. And you should say thank you very much for good judgment.
We're doing a great job.
We're doing a great job.
We've done a great job.
I think that we've done a fantastic job from just about every standpoint.
And on a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate your response to this crisis?
I'd rate it a 10. There's going to be nobody better than Donald Trump in terms of bipartisanship. Because, you see, I know the truth. And people out there in the world, they really don't know the truth. They don't know what it is. And all you have to do is look at the approval numbers on the job we're doing. I think we're doing an incredible job. The American public thinks that we've handled it well, if you look at polling data. But I'm not interested in myself. I don't think I would have done any better had I not been impeached. Okay? And I think that's a great tribute to something. Maybe it's a tribute to me. When governors call me, they'll say, thank you, you are the greatest president that's ever lived. And a lot of people love Trump, right? A lot of people love me. You see him all the time, right? I guess I'm here for a reason, you know? To the best of my knowledge, I won.
Tuning into these briefings, they want to get information and guidance and want to know what to do. They're not looking for rumors.
I'm the president and you're fake news.
Trump macht Schluss. Die USA brechen ihre Beziehungen mit der Weltgesundheitsorganisation ab. Sie haben es versäumt, dringend nötige Reformen anzustoßen. Deswegen werden wir heute unsere Zusammenarbeit mit der WHO beenden.
So many names. I could give you 19 or 20 names for that, right? It's got all different names. Wuhan. Wuhan was catching on. Coronavirus, right? Kung flu, yeah.
It's one person coming in from China.
What do you say to Americans who are concerned that you're not taking this seriously enough and that some of your statements don't match what your health experts are saying?
That's CNN, fake news. She's shocked that I picked her.
No.
She's like in a state of shock.
I'm not thinking, Mr.
That's
President.
Okay, I know you're not thinking. You never do.
I'm sorry?
I know you're not thinking. You never do. I know you're not thinking. You never do.
Do you think that right now the nation needs you to express that same sort of comfort and healing that some people need to heal?
Right now, I think the nation needs law and order.
Exploiting this tragedy to loot, rob, attack, and menace. Hatred, chaos, rioters, looters, and anarchists. Violence and vandalism led by Antifa, radical left-wing groups, terrorizing the innocent, destroying jobs, burning down buildings. The mobs are devastating the life's work of good people. Anarchy. Anarchy. Criminals and vandals wreck our cities and lay waste to our communities. Mob violence. Radical left criminals, thugs, an angry mob. Angry mobs. It is essential that we protect the crown jewel of American democracy. The rule of law, violence, mayhem, and disorder. An angry mob rioting, I am your president of law and order. Professional anarchists, violent mobs, arsonists, looters, criminals, rioters, Antifa, dangerous thugs. Domestic terror, anarchy, hatred, chaos, rioting and looting, destruction and arson. Riots and lawlessness spread throughout our country. Rioting, looting, vandalism, assaults, and the wanton destruction of property. Down.
mix. I were black, you were white. You would always win the fight. Bang, bang, you shot me down. Bang, bang.
Now it's time to open it up. And you know what? The people of our country are warriors, and I'm looking at it. I'm not saying anything is perfect. And yes, will some people be affected? Yes. Will some people be affected badly? Yes. But we have to get our country open.
Again, our testing is so far advanced, it's so much bigger and better than any other country, that we're going to have more cases. We're always going to have more cases. And if we stop testing right now, we'd have very few cases, if any.
So the economy is roaring back. The plague, as I call it, the virus is abating. We know how to handle it. We know where to go and how to do it.
There were no tests for a new virus, but now we have tested almost 40 million people. By so doing, we show cases, 99% of which are totally harmless.
Yeah, the president has said unmistakably that he wants schools to open. And I was just in the Oval talking to him about that. And when he says open, he means open and full, kids being able to attend each and every day at their school. The science should not stand in the way of this. Science should not stand in the way of this.
I were black, you were white. You would always win the fight. Bang, bang, you shot me down. Bang, bang, I hit the ground. Bang, bang.
Not gonna wear a life jacket. I can't move my arms when I'm wearing the life jacket, and it makes me look kind of girly. The thing is, I have a constitutional right to not wear the life jacket. Where's the iceberg from? Where did the iceberg come from? I think we need to make it come from a country and make it racist. It's actually only bad where the iceberg hit the boat. Everything else is fine. Like, my area of the boat is safe. Don't you think it's weird? Don't you think it's a little weird that it's an election year and we're talking about an iceberg? Who set this up? Why are we talking about an iceberg in an election year? I'm just saying we wouldn't talk about it as much if it wasn't an election year. Heard the iceberg is a Democratic hoax. I don't know if you read anything about that. First it was life jackets, now we gotta get in lifeboats. It's weird you keep contradicting yourself. Oh, a lifeboat will save my life. That's an interesting way to look at it, but I have a card I will show you right now where my doctor says I don't have to get in a lifeboat. You guys can do what you wanna do. I'll do what I wanna do. We'll see what happens. Oh, I'm drowning now? You're saying I'm drowning and I'm gonna die. Okay, all right, well. Why isn't anyone taking this more seriously? People should take this more seriously.
No, I don't take responsibility at all. No, I don't take responsibility at all.